Olive found herself on a huge lily pad in the middle of a pond. She was wearing a pointy hat and sparkly shoes. Nearby, some frogs were having a party.
Cake? Is this a birthday party?
Oh, no, it's no one's birthday. Us frogs just love to dance and party. You can join us if you like.
Yes, please. I love dancing. Almost as much as I love honey sandwiches, that is.
As Olive danced and ate her sandwich, she noticed a little frog sitting all on his own.
Hello, I'm Olive. What's your name?
Ribbit. Ribbit Patterson.
Why aren't you dancing? There's honey sandwiches too. And look, now everyone's catching flies.
I'm useless at catching flies. The other big frogs always laugh at me when I try.
Said Ribbit sadly.
Well, I won't laugh at you.
I couldn't even catch that fly over there and it's really close.
Ribbit whipped out his tongue, only it was too short and he couldn't reach the fly.
Hey, Ribbit, look and learn, sunshine.
Called one of the bigger frogs. Olive and Ribbit ducked as the frog's massive tongue flew over their heads, caught the fly, then pulled it back into his mouth.
You see, I'll never catch flies like they can.
Olive looked over at the party. She spied some party blowers next to a big pot of honey on the table.
Party blowers? Some honey? I think I may have an idea.
Olive dunked the party blower into the pot of sticky honey, then popped it into her beak like a rolled-up tongue.
Look, Olive.
Ribbit pointed to a fly sitting on a strange-looking plant. With all her might, Olive blew the sticky party blower. Only she missed, and it stuck to the strange plant instead.
Let me try,
exclaimed Ribbit. But Olive had used too much honey, and the party blower was now stuck fast to her beak, as well as the plant.
It's stuck, it won't come off.
Suddenly, the plant began to rise out of the water.
Olive, why is the plant moving?
It wasn't a plant at all, but a very angry-looking crocodile. It swam off down the pond, dragging Olive with it.
Crocodile, it'll eat us all up.
Panicked Ribbit. Ribbit knew he had to do something, so he grabbed a spatula from one of the cakes and a party blower that he dipped in honey and waited for the crocodile to swim past him. Just as the crocodile got close, Ribbit blew the party blower as hard as he could and hit the crocodile. Ribbit was yanked off the lily pad and landed right on the crocodile's back.
Whoa, I've never surfed on a crocodile before.
Ribbit used the spatula to unstick Olive's party blower.
Oh, I'm free.
Jump, Olive.
They both leapt to safety, just as the crocodile snapped up behind them.
Oh, Ribbit, you were magnificent!
Magnificent? He's the bravest frog on the whole pond!
The big frogs lifted Ribbit onto their shoulders and declared him and Olive the party guests of honour.
Good catch, Ribbit! My turn. A little less honey.
But Olive missed and caught a cupcake instead.
I never did fancy flies much. Cupcakes are far more tasty.
They all laughed, and as they did, Olive realised it was time to go.
Oh, typical Olive, daydreaming again,
said her mum.
Cake, actually, I helped a frog to catch a crocodile.
Your head's been in the sand too long, dear,
said Olive's dad. Her little brother laughed. But Olive wasn't listening. She was already dreaming of her next big adventure.
Olive the Ostrich!
Olive was standing in a city street with a group of people taking pictures.
Hola, I am Bernard, your tour guide,
said a young man to the group.
But I'm sorry, this morning's tour of Barcelona is cancelled.
Excuse me, I'm Olive. Why can't we go on the tour?
Bernat pointed to the tourist train.
Our train has broken down and I can't get it fixed until tomorrow.
Oh. Well, perhaps we could explore on foot instead.
Oh, no. Barcelona is huge. Too big to explore in one morning without a train. I will find a mechanic. Maybe you could all find a cafe or look at some sights close by.
So while the rest of the group went to sit in a cafe, Olive wandered off looking for somewhere interesting to visit.
Oh, there's a nice little art gallery. I might pop inside.
Hola, welcome. I'm Joanna Biro, artist. This is my gallery.
Hola, I'm Olive. I love these paintings.
Oh, gracias. All were painted by me. They are views of Barcelona. But I have not sold one painting all year. I cannot get anyone to come inside and look. Oh. They are all too busy seeing the sights.
Hmm. An artist with paintings she can't sell? A broken down tourist train? I think I may have an idea. Joanna, I think I know how to get more people to buy your paintings.
You do?
First, I need you to find me a tall, very long roll of paper.
You know, Olive, I think I have just the thing.
Joanna ran to the back of the gallery and brought back a huge paper roll.
Is this big enough?
Oh, yes, that's perfect. Now, we need to stick your paintings of Barcelona onto this roll.
Olive and Joanna worked together, sticking on the paintings. Then they carried the roll back to the tourist train. When they arrived, Olive rounded everyone up and made an announcement.
Bernard's tour of Barcelona is going ahead.
But the train is still not repaired, Olive.
Don't worry, Bernard. All you have to do is get everyone on board.
Okay, then. Step this way, everyone. It seems we are going to see beautiful Barcelona after all. Okay, let our tour begin. We start by traveling along the famous street known as Las Ramblas.
Olive and Joanna unrolled the giant sheet of paper onto which they'd stuck Joanna's paintings. The tourists saw the paintings of Las Ramblas sliding by. It looked just like the real thing.
Next, we reach Gaudi Sagrada Familia Cathedral. And now, the Parque Güell with his famous dragon. And finally, the home of FC Barcelona, the Camp Nou football stadium. And that, ladies and gentlemen, concludes our tour of Barcelona.
The tour was an amazing success.
If anybody wants to buy a painting, Joanna's gallery is open right now.
Everyone did want to buy a painting. In no time at all, Joanna sold every single one.
Thank you so much, Olive.
Yes, I am grateful too. You saved the tour today. Maybe you would like to help me on my train once it is repaired.
Thanks, Bernard. But I'm sure you'll be okay. Soon your tour of Barcelona will be right back on track.
They all laughed. And as they did, Olive realised it was time to go.
Ah, typical Olive, daydreaming again.
Said her mum.
Geg, actually, I helped give a very artistic tour of Barcelona.
Your head's been in the sand too long, dear.
Said Olive's dad. Her little brother laughed. But Olive wasn't listening. She was already dreaming of her next big adventure.